This is our the next topic, the operational amplifiers. Okay, basically operational amplifier is a direct coupled differential input single ended output amplifier. Let me write here, it is a differential input. I will discuss each and every term. Differential inputs, single output, single ended output, and direct coupled. DC, high gain, voltage amplifier. Okay, basically it is a multi-stage amplifier. There are number of stages in the amplifier, this operational amplifier. And those stages are directly coupled to each other. That's why this term originates here, direct coupled. DC means direct coupled, not direct current. Okay, that means the stages are directly connected to each other. There are different mechanism of coupling the stages in electronics. For example, one of the technique is to use a capacitor. RC coupling is one of the technique. Transistor coupling is another technique. Okay, but in the operational amplifier, these stages are connected directly to each other without using any coupling. Okay, differential input means the difference operational amplifier receives differential signal only. Okay, that means anything which is applied between its two input terminals, that will be sensed by this amplifier. Okay, its symbol, let me draw the symbol for this differential amplifier, that will make the things more clear. What it has two input terminals, one is negative input and another one is positive input terminal. The output terminal here, if I write here V1, negative input voltage, positive input voltage V2, and V0 as a output. So you can see that differential input means anything applied between the terminal V1 and V2. Okay. In a normal amplifier, single ended input amplifiers, what we have, we apply the input signal between the input terminal and the ground. Okay. But what we do here, we apply the input signal between these two terminals, V1 and V2. Okay. If a difference voltage appears between these two terminals, this amplifier will sense that and amplify that difference. Okay, so that's why this term comes, differential inputs. But output, you can see that is taken between this terminal and the ground, so that's why it is single ended output. Okay, there is only one terminal for the output voltage, so single ended output. And the stages are, of course, it offers very high voltage gain. Okay, the typical voltage gain for one operational amplifier is, let's say, 2 × 10⁶. Okay, it offers such a high gain. So that's why the definition of the differential amplifier is given like this. It's a differential input, single ended output, direct coupled, and high gain voltage amplifier. Okay, and of course for any amplifier there should be a power supply, because the power supply delivers the power to the into the output signal. So we'll have two power supply here, one is called VCC and another one is minus VEE or minus VCC, you can say. Okay, it has dual power supply. One supply will be connected here and another one is connected here. Okay, is it clear? But normally these two terminals are not shown, only what is shown are the two input terminals and one output terminal. Okay, if it is not shown, that means there is a power supply, two power supply, which are actually not shown in the given diagram or picture. But for any amplifier, the power supply is integrated part. Okay. Basically, this operational amplifier comes in a IC form, integrated circuit form. Okay. In IC form, IC means integrated circuit. I hope that you have seen an integrated circuit earlier. Okay, integrated circuit means whatever is there in that operational amplifier, everything is fabricated on the single substrate. Okay, that means if let us say more than 20 transistors are needed to design one operational amplifier, so all those 20 transistors are put on a single chip. Okay, you cannot distinguish each and every transistors. Okay, so the package operational amplifier, the package of the operational amplifier comes in integrated circuit form, IC form. Okay, one of the example for the integrated operational amplifier is IC741. Okay, IC741. Another one may be LM10 or LM101. These two are from the Texas Instruments. Okay. This IC741 is the most popular operational amplifier IC, and basically it has 8 different pins. What you observe here, that there were 2 inputs, 1 output and 2 power supply. So you can get one impression that there are only 4-5 pins in the operational amplifier. But actually, one operational amplifier IC741 has total 8 pins. Okay, let me tell you the role of each and every pin. If I draw the top view of an IC741, basically it appears like this. What you will see, that there will be cut mark on the top. Okay, that is shown here. This one is to indicate from where to you have to start. Okay, so if the cut mark is here, I will start from here. So you will see that there are 4 pin towards the left, 1, 2, 3, and 4, 1, 2, 3, and 4, and there are 4 another pins here, 5, 6, 7, and 8. So this is pin diagram for IC741. Okay. This input, which is called inverting input. Okay. The input V1, it is because it is connected to this negative terminal. It is called inverting input. Inverting because the output V0 will be out of phase with this input pin. Okay. That means if you apply a positive voltage here, the output will be out of phase. That means there will be 180 degree phase shift between output and input voltage. However, if you apply a signal here at this input terminal, that will be in phase with the output signal. So this V1 is called inverting input. Inverting input, and V2 is called non-inverting input. It becomes more clear later on why it is called inverting and non-inverting. Okay, at this moment, the simple reason is the output voltage will be in out of phase with this V1. That's why it is inverting input V1, and V2 will be in phase with V0. That's why it is called non-inverting input. Okay, so here the pin number 2 is basically non-inverting input. Pin number 2 is for inverting input. It should be like this. Pin number 2 is for inverting input, 3 is for non-inverting input, 6 is the output. You will get output at the pin number 6, ok. Inverting input will be applied to pin number 2, non-inverting will be applied to pin number 3, ok. As you know that there are two power supplies, so negative power supply has to be connected at pin number 4 here, and the positive power supply has to connected at pin number 7, ok. Generally for IC741 you can apply plus minus 15 volt power supply, ok. That means you can apply plus 15 volt DC at pin number 7 and minus 15 volt DC at pin number 4. So, plus minus 15 volt power supply, DC power supply is used, ok. But apart from these 5 pins, you can notice that there are 3 more pins, ok. One is pin number 1, this pin number 1 is basically called offset null pin, ok. One is called offset null pin. Similarly, 5 is also offset null pin. Offset null pin, 8 is basically no connection, ok. It is left open just to maintain the symmetry in the pins, ok. So, 8 has not any role to play, 1 is offset null pin, this 5 is again offset null pin, ok. You may think here what is the role of these offset null pins. Okay, so, reason is pretty simple. If you do not apply any signal at the input terminals 2 and 3, you will not expect any output at the pin number 6, ok. But because of the manufacturing problems or the issues during the manufacturing, what will happen, because of the mismatching of transistor parameters, even without giving input, you may find some output here if power supply is connected, ok. So, because of that region, you will see that there will be offset output present at pin number 6, and we have to somehow remove that output, ok. So, to remove that output voltage, we need to apply a potential between pin number 1 and 5 in such a magnitude that the potential here goes to 0, ok. I mean, the potential applied between pin number 1 and 5 will cancel the potential, undesired potential which was there at pin number 6. So, that is the role of this offset null pins, ok. You need to apply positive voltage between 1 and 5 or negative voltage between 1 and 5 depending upon the polarity of potential at pin number 6, ok. So, this is a differential, you have to apply a DC voltage between 1 and 5 between the at the offset null pins to cancel out any undesired output if it is present at the pin number 6. But generally if the transistors are well fabricated, then you will see that you need to apply 0 potential between pin number 1 and 5. Generally you need not to apply because the potential here will be at 0 if we apply power supply and do not give the input signals between 2 and 3, ok. Is it clear? So, in brief, these are the roles of the different pins. Now, let me give you the block diagram, what is there inside this integrated circuit, ok, in this inside this operational amplifier. So, as I have told you, it is a multi-stage amplifier. There are 4 different important stages which are there inside this integrated circuit. The first stage is a differential amplifier, ok. Its differential amplifier means it receives input between the 2 input terminals, ok, and produce output here, differential output. So, the stage 1 is differential amplifier, the output of differential amplifier is sent to amplifiers, particularly this amplifier is for providing the sufficient gain, and after providing the gain, the signal will be passed through a level shifter, and the output of this level shifter will be given to a common collector amplifier. Common collector amplifier. And this is your output. Okay. So, what you see here that there are four different blocks, important blocks in integrated circuit IC741 or in an operational amplifier. The first one is differential amplifier. The role of this differential amplifier is to provide some differential gain as well as to provide high input impedance, to offer high input impedance to the signal. Okay. So, if you look into from between these two terminals, you will observe a very high input impedance. Okay. So, differential amplifiers basically offers very high input impedance, whether if they are made, they can be made from bipolar junction transistor, or you can also use MOSFETs to implement the differential amplifiers. Okay. A simple configuration for differential amplifier may be like this. We can use two transistors in this manner. To get a differential amplifier, this is RC here, RC, VCC, and this is minus VEE. Okay. So, one input is here, another input is here. So, these two inputs are actually the input of this differential amplifier, which is shown outside of the block. Okay. These are nothing but the two base terminals of two bipolar junction transistors. Okay. Or if you use MOSFETs, if you you can also use MOSFETs to design differential amplifier, and in that case the circuit topology will be similar. The only difference is these two inputs are basically the gate of two different MOS transistors. Okay. In this case, these are the base of the two NPN transistors. If you choose to design differential amplifier with MOSFETs, then in that case, this will be the gate of two transistors. Okay. And as you know that the base current is quite small, the transistors are designed in such a way that the order of base current is in nanoampere. Okay. And for the MOSFETs, you know that since there is a insulator between gate terminal and the channel of the device, there is a no gate current flowing, means zero gate current. So, because of the very low current either entering into the transistors, two transistors, the input impedance offered by this device is quite high. The input impedance offered by the differential amplifier is quite high, because you know that Ri equal to Vi upon I, and since the I level, the current level is very low because of the base current or the gate current. If you choose the different methods of implementation, this Ri becomes very high. Okay. And that is very much needed for a voltage amplifier. The input impedance should be very, very high. Okay. So, this is there inside in this block, I mean this differential amplifier is implemented in this manner. Okay. The two inputs, the things to remember is the two inputs of this differential amplifier are basically connected with the base of the two transistors. Okay. Then there is a next stage to offer the gain for this. As you know that this transistor offer very high, this integrated circuit operational amplifier offers very high gain of the order of 2 into 10 to the power 6. Okay. So, this much gain cannot be offered by a single stage, single transistor or single amplifier. Okay. So, in this gain stage, there may be multiple amplifiers cascaded to provide such a high gain. Okay. And basically Darlington pairs are used, or common emitter amplifiers can be used to provide most of the gain offered by the operational amplifiers. Okay. So, after this gain stage, there will be level shifter. If there is a shifting in the level of the output signal, that will be adjusted by this level shifter stage. And finally, the output of level shifter stage will be given to the common collector amplifier, and the output of this common collector amplifier will be the output of this operational amplifier. Okay. As you know that the common collector amplifier offers very low output impedance. I have already discussed about this, that this common collector amplifier has very high input impedance, very low output impedance. Okay. Just to use that important fact that it offers very low output impedance, here we use common collector amplifier. This common collector amplifier has nothing, because you know that the gain offered by this common collector amplifier is 1. So, definitely it is not connected here for getting gain, it is connected here for only getting low output impedance. Okay. So, let me now summarize the important characteristics of this operational amplifier. Let me first do it for an ideal operational amplifier. What are the desired characteristics for an ideal operational amplifier, and then I will write the corresponding value for a practical IC741. Okay. So, for any voltage amplifier, the voltage gain should be very high, as you know. Okay. So, here I write parameters which are being discussed for ideal operational amplifier and for practical, let us say that it is IC741. Okay. So, voltage gain, the first parameter for a voltage amplifier must be voltage gain. Okay. So, the voltage gain, as it is very obvious, should be very, very high. Okay. So, for ideal case, let us say that it is infinity, but for practical case for IC741, it may be 2 × 10⁶. Okay. It is still very high gain, 2 × 10⁶. Okay. Then one of the important parameter for a amplifier is the input resistance, RI. Okay. The input resistance. So, the input resistance again for an ideal amplifier should be infinite. Okay. The output impedance, the input impedance for an ideal one is infinite, but it is again very high for IC741, although it is not infinite, in the order of 1 mega ohm, 1 mega ohm, 2 mega ohm, depending upon how the operational amplifier is fabricated, it is a typical range in the mega ohm. Okay. Mega ohm is a very high value. The output resistance should be ideally 0, okay. But practically we can get around 75 ohm. In case of IC741, okay. Output impedance should be 0 for a voltage amplifier, input impedance should be infinite, but practically we get around 20 ohm, 30, 40, 50, 70, like that, depending upon how the device is fabricated and what parameters are considered during the fabrication. Okay. There is another parameter that is called the bandwidth of an amplifier. Bandwidth determines what is the frequency range of the input signal which is allowed to pass through that amplifier. Okay. That means, it is not necessary that your signal is always sinusoidal signal. Your signal may be complex signal like a triangular signal or any other random signal, and that signal will have a variety of frequencies. Sinusoidal frequency, if you look at the spectrum of the signal, you will find that a particular signal consists of a large number of frequency components. Okay. And if it is so, if you want to amplify that input signal, all those frequency components should be amplified. Okay. And that is possible, this amplification is possible if the bandwidth of the amplifier is quite large. Okay. So, the bandwidth for an ideal operational amplifier should be infinite, then only it will pass all frequency with amplifications. Okay. Whereas, for the IC741, it will be few megahertz, let me write it 1 megahertz. Okay. These are the important characteristics, and you should remember these characteristics, because these are quite useful while solving the numerical problems. Okay. And now let me give the terminal equations for this IC741, for this operational amplifier. If I consider the inputs to be, input voltage to be V1 and V2, the output voltage is V0. Okay. Please note here, if power supply is not shown, that means it is inherently there in the circuit, but it is not shown, okay, because this is the customary, this is the actually custom of drawing the symbol for this operational amplifier. Okay. So, we can relate the output voltage V0 with the input signals V1 and V2, okay, in this manner. The V0 is actually the voltage gain AVO into V2 minus V1. Okay. And please note here, this voltage gain which was infinite here, this same voltage gain which is denoted by AVO. Okay. I have written here the suffix VO, this indicates the voltage gain in open loop condition. Okay. AVO is voltage gain in open loop condition. In open loop voltage gain, you can say open loop voltage gain. Okay. So, if you have open loop voltage gain, that means we also have some kind of closed loop voltage gain. Okay. I will tell you why these two terms are needed, open loop voltage gain and closed loop voltage gain. Okay. But before that, let us focus here. V0 equal to AVO V2 minus V1. Is it clear? Okay. Now, you see that for the case of ideal operational amplifier, if I consider this operational amplifier to be an ideal, then I can write here that V2 minus V1 is V0 upon AVO. Is it or not? I am just playing with the terms here, rearranging the terms, and can write V2 minus V1 equal to V0 upon AVO. Okay. And if you note down the gain, open loop voltage gain, for an ideal case which is infinite here. Okay. If I say that this AVO is tending towards infinity, then the V0 upon AVO, it must go towards 0. Is it or not? If AVO is very high, very large, in ideal case if it is infinite, then I can directly say that this V0 upon infinity is simply 0. Okay. And what does it says? It says a very interesting thing, that V2 becomes equal to V1. Is it clear? Okay. Because of this high gain, very high gain, okay, if you apply something at one terminal, the potential of another terminal will follow that potential. Okay. That means it is just like a short circuit condition. Is it or not? Short circuit means what? Short circuit means what you do? You connect two different nodes in a circuit by a wire. Okay. And what happens as a result? If you connect the two nodes by a wire, that means both nodes now are having the same potential. Okay. But here the two nodes are physically connected to each other. In this case, what you see, although the two nodes, the two inputs V1 and V2 are not physically connected, but they are behaving like a physically connected nodes. Okay. And therefore, it is said to be a virtual short condition. This is said to be, this V1 and V2 is said to be, V1 equal to V2 is said to be a virtual short, condition. Okay. That means, although the two nodes are not physically connected, but they are tracking the potential of each other. Okay. If I apply something at V1, V2 will follow. If the device is having very high open loop gain. Okay, it's true only when AVO is tending towards infinity. Is it clear or not? Okay. So this is called virtual short. Now just focus on, again focus on this equation, V0 equal to AVO into V2 minus V1. Now I will tell you why we have two different voltage gain, open loop voltage gain and another one is called closed loop voltage gain. The reason for having these two voltage gain is as follows. Okay. You know that this AVO is infinity in ideal case, whereas in practical case even this is quite high, 2 into 10 to the power 6. Okay. Let's say that I have to amplify a 1 millivolt input signal. Okay. Let's say that I have a 1 millivolt input signal applied between V1 and V2. Okay. Or let's say that our VID, which is V2 minus V1, is 1 millivolt. Okay. If I directly apply this signal to the operational amplifier, what I am going to get? What I am expected to get at the output terminal? V0 equal to gain into input voltage. Okay. Gain is 2 into 10 to the power 6 and input voltage is 1 millivolt. Okay. Let's say that this was a sinusoidal signal and peak of that input sinusoidal was 1 millivolt. So now the peak of the output voltage is going to be how much? 2000 volt. Okay. But this is impossible for a circuit. Okay. No amplifier can provide such a high output voltage. Okay. You should note down a fact that the maximum amplitude of the output signal for an amplifier cannot go above the power supply level. Getting my point? For example, if the power supply for a given operational amplifier is plus minus 15 volt, so output signal level cannot go above 15 volt or cannot go below minus 15 volt. Okay. But if this amplification is performed for the using this operational amplifier, you are expected to get this 2000 volt. Okay. So the point is, it is not possible. You cannot get such a high gain. I mean, you cannot get such a high voltage at the output because your transistors which are there in the circuit get saturated. Okay. Your output voltage will saturate at plus 15 volt or minus 15 volt depending upon the polarity of the signal. Okay. Output never goes above plus 15 volt or below minus 15 volt. That means the proper amplification for this signal is not possible. Okay. So you can see that even the gain offered by this operational amplifier is quite high, 10 to the power, in the range of 10 to the power 6. But if you directly use this gain to amplify a signal, it leads to a impractical situation. Okay, you cannot directly utilize this very high gain for amplification purpose. So therefore, what is done? The operational amplifier is kept under closed loop condition. Okay, and under the closed loop condition, if we use some kind of negative feedback, the gain reduces to a practical value. Okay, what may be the practical value of gain? Maybe 10, 100, 50, 60, like that. Okay, so somehow we have to reduce this 10 to the power 6 gain to a lower value, to a practical gain of the 10 20 50 30, like that. And for that purpose, we need to keep this operational amplifier into the closed loop condition with the negative feedback. Okay, and that's why we have two different gains. One is open loop gain, which is very very high, and another one is a closed loop gain, which is a practical gain, and that gain is actually used for signal amplification in the real practice. Okay, is it clear? The gain offered by the operational amplifier is very high, but we cannot use the signal in a differential mode. We cannot use the operational amplifier in a differential mode. We cannot directly use this, but we have to put this operational amplifier in some sort of negative feedback to reduce the gain, and then only with the reduced gain the signals are amplified. Okay, is it clear?